Hi guys! In this video, I'm going to discuss the blood flow in tendons and how it affects the healing process. Now, you may have heard that tendons have really poor blood supply and that's why they heal so slowly. And I'm hoping that I can explain to you today that you understand that you don't really have to worry about that part so much. So, for those of you who don't know me, my name is Maryke. I'm one of the physiotherapists from treatmyachilles.com, where you can get online physiotherapy assessment as well as treatment for your Achilles injuries. So have a look at the description of this video if you want a link to our website. Okay, so what's the deal with tendons and blood flow? Yes, tendons do have a poorer blood flow compared to muscle tissue, for instance. But to be honest, muscles have evolved to need that much blood flow because of the way that they function and act. Tendons have evolved to need this much blood flow for the way that they react and work. So although it's less blood flow and poorer blood supply compared to muscle tissue, it is the perfect blood supply for tendon tissue. So it's not that unhealthy or injured tendon tissue now has a poorer blood supply than what a healthy tendon has. In fact, if you look under the microscope at a tendon with a tendinopathy, or under the ultrasound where you can see the blood vessels and things as well, you'll see that actually an injured tendon has more blood flow and blood vessels growing into it than an uninjured tendon has. So it's important to understand this, that yes, in research we wanted to understand why certain structures may heal slower than others. But just because one of the things we think is going on here is that it has less blood supply than muscle tissue, for instance, doesn't mean that that's a fault in the tendon. The tendon, that's normal for a tendon, even in a healthy tendon, and it's evolved to function that way. So if you now start reading about that and thinking, oh, well, if it's got a poor blood supply, then the way to get it to heal better is to increase this blood flow. So let's do things to increase the blood flow. Now, the typical thing I see is people really applying loads of heat, thinking that's going to improve the blood flow. It's not really. It's never going to go above the maximum that it can do. Plus, remember, our regulatory system is pretty good. So if it becomes, because the body doesn't want to be too hot either, otherwise it will get tissue damage. Now, as soon as you heat the area up, the skin opens the blood vessels and yeah, you flush the area. But that doesn't mean you're even flushing the tendon. And remember, if you heat it too excessively and you do actually get to the point where you're now starting to significantly increase that tendon's temperature, you can again give yourself a different type of injury, a heat injury. So don't get so caught up with the fact that you've read somewhere that the blood flow to the tendon isn't great. That's just normal tendons for you, and it's just an explanation of why the healing process is slow. And you can't increase that blood flow significantly enough through external things to speed up the healing process either. The way to get better if you've got a tendinopathy or a tendon injury is relative rest plus careful loading. Relative rest means you take out all the super irritating stuff. So for instance, if running hurts or if walking hurts or if jumping hurts, you've got to reduce that, because no amount of blood flow will help that tendon recover if you're still overloading it through doing activities that it's not ready for. And then combined with the relative rest is careful strength training to get those fibers to renew, because you've got to remember that those collagen fibers can only renew and rebuild stronger if you're actually stimulating them through strength training to rebuild stronger. But again, on that note, it doesn't mean that you just jump in with strength training. It's got to be at the right level for you. So have a look. We've got videos about that as well. But yes, to wrap up, yes, tendons do have a poorer blood supply than other tissues like muscle tissue, but it's normal for a tendon to have that blood supply. It's not due to the injury. And healthy tendons have that blood supply, and they've evolved to have that blood supply. So don't worry about it. Worry about getting your load management right and your exercise therapy right. Very well. Let me know if you've got any questions. And remember, if you need more help with an injury in your Achilles, you can always consult one of us via video call. The link is in the description of this video. Take care.